Anticipation and expectations abound. Every State of the Nation address or sauna, as every guest in the actual venue and those outside the ordinary Filipinos want to hear what they have always been hoping for actually realized. Judging from the applause the president received, it's clear that many of those in attendance were satisfied with how he has performed thus far. But many became even more ecstatic for a development regarding a venture that has been mired by controversy and allegations of criminal activities. Alan Francisco has the full report.
Starting today, the Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs are banned in the Philippines. This was emphasized by President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. in his State of the Nation Address or SONA. The President directed the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation or PAGCOR to wind down and cease the operations of POGOs by the end of the year. Meanwhile, he instructed the Department of Labor and Employment or DOLE to collaborate with economic managers to provide employment opportunities for Filipino POGO workers who will be affected by the closure.
At ngayon po, naririnig po namin ang malakas na sigaw ng taong bayan laban sa mga POGO. Disguising as legitimate entities, their operations have ventured into illicit areas furthest from gaming, such as financial scamming, money laundering, prostitution, human trafficking, kidnapping, brutal torture, even murder. The grave abuse and disrespect to our system of laws must stop. Kailangan nang itigil ang panggulo nito sa ating lipunan at paglalapastangan sa ating bansa. Effective today, all POGOs are banned. I hereby instruct PAGCOR to wind down and cease the operations of POGOs by the end of the year. The DOLE, in coordination with our economic managers, shall use the time between now and then to find new jobs for our countrymen who will be displaced.
President Marcos also reiterated the country's rights over the West Philippine Sea, advocating for peaceful means to resolve the issue.
We are now more conscious as a people and strategic in heightening our aerial and maritime domain awareness. We are continuing to strengthen our defensive posture, both through developing self-reliance and through partnerships with like-minded states. Ang West Philippine Sea ay hindi katang-isip natin lamang. Ito ay atin. Ito ay manang... At ito ay mananatiling atin hanggat nag-aalab ang diwa ng ating minamahal na bansang Pilipinas. Pagtitibayin at palalaguin natin ang kamalayan at kaalaman ng buong bansa at titiyakin na maipapasa natin ito sa kabataan at ating susunod na mga salinlahi. Laws on our maritime zones and archipelagic sea lanes make sure that this intergenerational mandate, this duty, will firmly take root in the hearts and minds of all our people. Sa buong sandatang lakas, sa Coast Guard, sa ating mga mangingisda sa West Philippine Sea, tagapimpunin niyo ang taus-pusong pasasalamat ng buong bansa dahil sa inyong ginagawang pagmamatyag at sakripisyo.
He also stressed the government's commitment to build and rehabilitate more dams and farm-to-market roads to boost agricultural production. He assured the government will continue to work to ensure food security and make food affordable to the public.
Nagsilbing kaagapay ng taong bayan ang kadiwa sa panahon na mataas ang presyo ng pagkain. Dahil naging epektibo ito, ang mga kadiwa centers ay magpapatuloy pa. Katuwang ang mga lokal na pamahalaan, dinagdagan pa natin ang mga kadiwa sa iba't ibang panig ng bansa. Higit sa lahat, layunin nating gawin permanente rin at mas madalas pa ang pagdaraos ng mga kadiwa.
President Marcos highlighted his anti-corruption program and vowed to pursue the completion of new specialty centers for cancer patients. He also announced that around 100 projects with a total investment amounting to 3 trillion pesos across multiple sectors are now Green Lane certified. He declared, "The country is in the middle of a railway renaissance," emphasizing the progress of various rail line projects. President Marcos also mentioned that 10 million unique user devices in over 13,000 areas in the country are benefiting from the government's free Wi-Fi program. For the education sector, he believes that Department of Education or DepEd Secretary Juan Edgardo Sani Angara will lead the department in providing quality education to students and focusing on the needs of teachers.
And so, as we build and upgrade schools, so too must we uplift and upskill our teachers, whose competence and trademark Filipino patience, determination, and compassion will be at the core of our national learning recovery. Dinagdagan natin ang mga empleyado ng hahalili sa mga guro upang magampanan ang mga sari-saring gawain sa paaralan. Sa gayon, ang ating mga guro ay makakatutok ng mabuti sa kanilang propesyon na pagtuturo.
He also emphasized the government's efforts in achieving a better economy, which includes job opportunities for Filipinos.
Our poverty rate has significantly dropped to 15.5%, down from 18% in 2021. This present figure is even lower than the pre-pandemic level of 16.7% in 2018. Ang katumbas nito ay halos 2.25 milyong Pilipino ang naiangat natin mula sa kahirapan.
The President also has a message for overseas Filipino workers.
Sa ating mga OFW, ayon sa datos ng Bangko Sentral, mahigit 37 bilyong dolyar ang naipasok sa bansa ng ating mga OFW noong nakalipas na taon. Sadyang napakalaking tulong nito sa ating bumabangon na ekonomiya. Kaya hindi lamang pasasalamat, kundi parangal ang ating ipinapaabot sa lahat ng ating mga OFW. Sana ay napapanood nila ito, ramdam na ramdam hanggang dito sa ating bansa ang inyong sakripisyo.
Alan Francisco from the National TV Network for a New and Better Philippines.